Let's convert a mesh file to a solid body, which will allow you to alter the design in Autodesk Fusion, which I am proud to partner with for this video. I'll also share some secrets to cleaning up meshes for those on the hobby license, and I'll answer some of the most asked STL questions. The simplest way to insert your mesh file is to head to the Insert menu, followed by Insert Mesh. Notice I'm in the Design workspace in the default Solid Modeling tab. You will also find the same Insert Mesh feature in the Mesh toolbar. Choose Select from my computer and select the desired file. Note that Fusion supports STL, OBJ, and 3MF mesh files, making it a versatile solution for designers who work with a variety of formats. Fusion also allows you to select and import multiple mesh files at the same time. After selecting Open, choose the unit type. STL and OBJ files are unitless, so you must select the correct unit type per your desired scale. 3MF files include units, so you will not be required to select a unit of measure. Note that if you import multiple mesh files at once, you cannot determine their unit of measure in the insert dialog. You'll be able to define that individually later on. This example STL file is imported in the correct orientation. However, you can always select flip up direction to reorient the model. Before looking at the position options, I'll first make the origin folder visible in the browser. Notice the bottom of the model is resting on the bottom origin plane. If you'd like to center the model to the origin, select the center option. Move to ground will align the bottom of the model to the bottom origin plane. Lastly, we can toggle open the numerical input section to further define the placement of the model. Of course, we can also push and pull the distance and rotation manipulators. Let's select OK and proceed with converting the mesh file. Let's look at all three types of mesh conversions that Fusion supports. Start with the Convert Mesh feature, found in the Modify menu of the Mesh tab. Take note of the gold icon in the Bodies folder, which signifies this is a mesh body. On occasion, your mesh file may end up as an orange surface body, so keep an eye on the body icons. We can select the mesh body in the browser or by selecting the model. Next, choose whether you want this to be parametric and recorded in the timeline, or if you would prefer to create a base feature that does not record upstream parametric relationships. Choose parametric if you'd like to retain the flexibility to make changes. The base feature option is great if you have a large mesh file or when you intend to make a lot of changes to the mesh, which may cause the parametric nature to slow down the file. Notice you'll get a warning message if your file has a significant number of triangles. The number of triangles, also called facets, will directly affect the amount of time this will take to convert. The three methods to convert mesh files to solid B-Rep bodies are faceted, prismatic, and organic. The prismatic option is what most users are looking for, as it converts our file into a solid body without the triangles. It essentially merges the faces and rebuilds the file as if it were built in Fusion. This option will produce the cleanest results, and Fusion is one of the most effective programs for converting files to editable bodies, ultimately allowing you to update your model using Fusion's native parametric tools. However, this conversion method is unfortunately not available to hobby users on the personal use license. Before we can use Prismatic, we'll need to use the feature called Generate Face Groups. This will help determine the boundary of each set of faces, including where the geometry changes in curvature. Face groups are required for Prismatic and help produce better results. After selecting the bodies, we can set the type to fast or accurate. When reverse engineering a model, I recommend always trying the accurate option first. Just note that this may not work with models with a large facet count. After selecting OK, it may take a bit to process. Notice after computing, the model sets a color for each unique face group. Keep in mind that this is a visual representation and does not affect the physical properties of the model. In the Inspect menu, you will find we can toggle the face groups on and off. You can also use Shift plus F. Now that we've defined our face groups, we can proceed with the prismatic conversion. As you can see, this results in a solid B-Rep body as if it were modeled in Fusion from scratch. You can then easily modify using offset faces, sketches, or other modeling features. Let's now look at the original faceted approach, which is currently the only option available to those on the free personal use license. I'll roll back the timeline and use Convert Mesh once again, this time selecting Faceted. After selecting OK, you'll see that in a few seconds, the file is converted to a solid body. Remember to verify the results by looking for the solid body icon in the browser. As you can see, the faceted method produces hundreds, if not thousands, of mesh facets. Consequently, it's much harder for us to modify and manipulate the file. Looking at these models side by side, you can see what a big difference the prismatic option makes. With the faceted result, you can select faces on the same planar surface, followed by the delete key. Fusion will then attempt to repair and merge them into a single face. Just make sure you're in the solid or mesh tabs. If you're in the surface tab, then it will delete the individual face. This technique works great for large planar surfaces, and if you intend to add some text or change the face, this may be sufficient. However, this trick does not work on curved surfaces. Keep in mind that Autodesk Fusion is one of the most versatile CAD tools in terms of different modeling types that can be used. Curved surfaces can be rebuilt using surfacing tools like sweep, patch, and loft. I explain that process in detail in this other lesson. If you only need to alter the size of one location, such as a hole or wall thickness, you'll find it easier to work with Fusion's mesh tools and avoid converting altogether. The third conversion method allows you to convert organic models to T-splines, allowing you to edit with Fusion's form tools. However, this method is only available if you have a commercial license and the design extension. Lastly, let's answer three of the most common Fusion questions specific to STL files. Number one, why is the STL file the wrong size when imported? Or why is the mesh file 10 times larger? STL files are unitless, meaning the file itself does not retain the original unit of measurement. When opening an STL file in Fusion via the file open or upload methods, the file will default to using centimeters. That is why I always recommend using the Insert Mesh menu, as we discussed earlier in this video, as it allows you to select the desired units. The second question, why does it take so long to export as an STL file? Whenever you go to File, Export, and choose STL, you're prompting Fusion to translate the files in the cloud on Autodesk servers. Instead, use the Save as Mesh feature by right-clicking on the component or body in the browser. You can also use the 3D print button, which leads you to the same dialog. This will save the mesh locally, processing it with your computer in a matter of seconds. Third question, why don't my threads show up in the mesh export? Whenever you're working with threads in Fusion, you'll need to check the modeled option if you want them to be physically modeled and included with the exported file. Otherwise, they'll remain a graphical image, which simplifies the file in case you have hundreds or thousands of screws throughout your assembly. Hit the like button if you learned something in this video and learn more about how you can access Autodesk Fusion via the link in the description. Check out our playlist, Learn Fusion for 3D Printing.